Weekend with the spring musical, which was a success. I've watched students in their end of year activities, exams, and all of the things that we get to this last couple of weeks of the school year, and often it's a celebration of all of the things that we've done. And whether that's a band concert, an AP exam, a kindergarten graduation, whatever it might be, and everything in between, these last couple of weeks are celebrations. And considering what the last 365 days plus have thrown at us, I think it's even more important that we celebrate each and every one of these milestones, because as we creep a little bit closer to normal, and we get to gather in an auditorium for a band concert or a graduation, and all the great stuff that's going to happen in the next couple of weeks, it's important to know that a lot of things had to happen behind the scenes for the last months upon months, overcoming all kinds of challenges to allow this band to sound as great as they're going to sound tonight. Their director, Mr. LaRusso, started coming to us last summer, proposing the idea of instrument PPE, which we hadn't ever heard of before, didn't know existed, and I'm not sure that anybody wanted to even know about it.
Yeah, it didn't exist.
But he found it. He presented us with the research and said, our band program, our music programs, we need to continue because it's so important to our students to have the arts in their life no matter what. And so, thanks to everyone for coming out tonight, being a part of our community. Thanks for coming out over the weekend for the musical. I hope to see you all many, many times over the coming weeks so that we can celebrate all the wonderful things that our students and their teachers have accomplished in this last year. Thank you.
I'm gonna go to the hospital. I'm gonna go get some more.
It sounds a lot different than it did with 16 kids, nine of which were drummers. So that was a lot of fun. The last piece we played, other than being a pirate sea shanty, which has become all the rage on social media, they tell me, that was written by Randall Sandage. And Randall Sandage composed a piece that we premiered as the Woodbridge 7th and 8th grade band at the concert in the park 4 years ago when these seniors and juniors were in 7th and 8th grade. So we wanted to make sure we did a piece by Randall Sandage. The next piece that we're going to play for you, or actually that these students standing in front of the stage are going to play for you, is an arrangement of Stevie Wonder's Sir Duke by our good friend Christopher Bill, famous YouTube trombone guy. But these five students, I realized as I was making the program this afternoon, these are the five students that represented Woodbridge at the PMEA virtual district band this year. So these they all deserve a round of applause for their efforts. The original plan was to have Christopher Bill come and play with us, but his schedule being what it is with the pandemic, he was unable to travel from New York this week. So filling in will be me. Yay. So a lot of you know this tune, 70s tune. We're going to play it as close to the original tempo as we can. It's really fast. It has a lot of notes in it. But this is a really exceptional group of students. So I think we're going to we'll try our best here. Thank you.
It'll be over soon.
Instrumental solo originally written for violin, which you already know that it's going to be harder to play on a barrett saxophone than on violin, because violin players don't have to breathe to make sound, they just go like this. So, violin solos, lots of notes, again, barrett sax, lots of, it's big, it's just lots of instrument. Because we have the proper distancing, I am going to let Brandon take his gigantic saxophone out of its bag to play the solo. So, this is Zardis. It's really hard, and he's really awesome. And he also made District Band this year, and last year, and the year before. Twice during the pandemic, which is pretty awesome. So, feature the next time the band on the saxophone, Brandon did.
Just a
Could you slide down, could you turn the monitors down just a little bit? Just a tiny, tiny bit. It's louder without a bag. Should I try again?
I'm going to go to the hospital.
I'm just walking over to say I'm glad we decided to stay inside. That rumble sound that you hear on the ceiling is...
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, before our last song, it is tradition, usually at the March concert, that we say thank you and goodbye to our seniors. This group of seniors has been through a lot in their 4 years, and I'm not just talking about the last 18 months. As freshmen, they performed a concert side by side with the Westchester University Wind Ensemble at their invitation, which for a program in a remote part of the state, not a very large school district, was a huge opportunity and a huge honor. As sophomores, they went to Florida and had a Locust Festival. Then at the end of their junior year was taken away, and their senior year they've been playing in masks and bags. So, as is tradition, they fill out a very short information page about them, and we honor them one at a time. There's no better place to start than Malachi Upright. Malachi has been in band for 8 years. His highlights are that he enjoyed the unique experiences that band brought him, including Westchester, Maryland, Florida, and caroling at the malls. His plans for next year are going to Johnson College for Computer Information Technology. His best memory of band was called Ricky every day of his freshman year. I just really, enjoyed the bonds I've created with everyone here, and I will truly miss them. Everybody, Malachi Upright. Next, Brian Gladson. Brian played for trumpet. He dabbled some poor little French horn. How many years have you been in band? Been in band for 8 years. Band highlights: county band, senior band celebration, participating in virtual district band. He was a member of the Village Union Wind Ensemble, Bandfest, Westchester, and he went to Florida. His plans for next year, he's going to attend Maryland University to major in medical laboratory sciences and continue to play in the band. It says it right here. During his best memory from his years of band, been with us everywhere, LaRusso asked if I ever wanted to punch him in the face, and I said yes. I should proofread these. During the lesson, Marilyn LaRusso said, and I quote, "You're so good at trumpet, I forgot how to head and wear the French horn." Nice. Everybody, I'm Ryan Gladson. Miss Holly Geyer. Holly's age is younger. She's been in band for 8 years. Her band highlights include County Country Band, Marywood Senior Wind Band Celebration, Northeast Union Wind Ensemble, District Band, Region Band, the trip to Westchester, multiple trips to Westchester, and the Florida trip. Plans for next year, going to Ithaca College for physical therapy, and the best memory from 4 years in band, making memes about LaRusso and interrupting everyone on the bus during the Florida trip. Everyone, Holly Geyer. Lexi Stone. Lexi plays the alto saxophone. She's been in band for 8 years. Her highlights include attending the Westchester trips, being in county band, and a junior wind band celebration. Plans for next year attending Keduka College for the occupational therapy program. Her best memory from her 4 years in band: my saxophone being stolen when I didn't even attend the Florida trip. Nice. She said, "Mr. Russo, take care of it." I said that you have nothing to worry about. That's not cool. Mr. Russo saying, after she had been remote most of this year, when Mr. Russo said it feels so good to be back here. What she said. Great host. Brandon Fruit. She's been a band for 7 years. Band highlights include attending Manchester Middle School, Marywood, Kent Crescendo at Marywood University, the Florida band trip, and the Westchester trips. The plans for next year include attending Hartwick College to major in biology, and her best memory from 4 years of band attending the Florida trip and meeting various people Mr. Russo has brought to teach us. Grand host. Olivia Colwell.
Haley's instrument is the B-flat clarinet. She also played bass clarinet. She's been in band for 8 years. Band highlights our only Florida trip and our trip to Westchester. Plans for next year to attend American University to major in accounting and possibly minor in forensic accounting and play in band. That's there on that one too. The best memory from 4 years of band, the random man barking at people in Florida and the Westchester trip in 2020. I see there's a theme here. Olivia Goldwell. Brandon Graves. Brianna plays the clarinet. She's been in band for 7 years. Our band highlights, why do you guys keep saying our only Florida trip? Our only Florida trip and our trip to Westchester. Plans for next year to attend Hofstra University to major in dance and possibly double major in business criminology. Her best memories from her years in band, the random guy barking at Olivia and I while we were in Florida, and Olivia crying on Jurassic Park ride and having a bunch of 12-year-olds look at us funny. Listen there. Marissa Derrick plays clarinet. She's been in band for 8 years. Her band highlights include Florida, attending Maryland Windmill celebrations, and Westchester. Plans for next year, she's going to Indiana University of Pennsylvania to study natural sciences. Her best memory from her years in band, accidentally taking the on a ride at Universal that she ended up crying and a bunch of 12-year-olds laughed at us. Hashtag bad best friend. Marissa Derrick. These three ladies, they set a record for, and I was keeping track. I keep track of these meticulous records. I don't think I ever had to tell them they were doing anything wrong musically more than once. It just magically fixed themselves. So amazing, amazing trick. Okay, next, Anthony Torrance. Anthony Torrance plays the French horn. He's been in band for 8 years. What did you play before French horn? Clarinet for a year. Okay. These band highlights include attending the Susquehanna University Honors Band Festival, PMEA, qualifying for the PMEA, district, region, and all-state bands and orchestras. Member of the Northeastern Youth Wind Ensemble, participating with the American Youth Wind Ensemble trips to, just one, right? To Italy. Pennsylvania Lions all-state band trip to Las Vegas, performing at Westchester and in Florida, and the Marywood Collegiate Brass Ensemble celebrations, etc. It's been a long time since somebody's filled all that up and then didn't have enough room. That's pretty awesome. Anthony and Jared were the first time in over 30 years that we've had two band students, both qualify for the All-State Festival in the same year. His plans for next year include studying at the University of Scranton as a presidential scholar, right? As a biochemistry major with pre-med trip. And his best memory from his 4 years of band was when Mr. Larissa convinced me to come with him to Italy to perform with American Youth Wind Ensemble. Anthony Torres. Last but certainly not least, your solo is extraordinary, Brandon Gentile. Brandon here plays the very sax. He's been in band for 8 years. His band highlights include Florida and district bands, Northeastern Youth Wind Ensemble. You joined that as a freshman. Northeastern? I think so. 4 year member of Northeastern Youth Wind Ensemble. Maryland One Band Celebration Festivals and all the counter bands that he could count. Plans for next year to attend Penn State Maine for architecture, and his best memory from his 4 years in band, freshman year with all of his friends and his sister in the band. Everybody, Brandon Gentile. I have one more recognition that I meant to do at the beginning of the concert, but I forgot. It's not a senior. Can Ian Cole please stand? When I got to Blue Ridge 10 years ago, there was a set of steps on the front of the stage that looked like it had been at Blue Ridge since before the buildings. And 3 or 4 years ago, I took them, I carried them downstairs, I threw them in the junk pile in Mr. Allen's woodshop and said, if you have a student over the next year or so that would like to rebuild these steps, well, months became years, and then everything that happened last year, and Ian stepped up this year, and we have a beautiful set of steps on the front of the stage that match this stage perfectly, so I wanted to make sure that I publicly thank you for your work. Thank you very much. Ian. It's time for the grand finale. This is usually when we would plug God Bless America. We're not in the park, so we're not doing God Bless America. I'm not going to make you sing. All right, let me do my thing, then you can do your thing. The piece that we're going to play for you would have been the piece that we would have performed at the Memorial Day Parades as a thank you to all our lost servicemen and women. We're not performing at the Memorial Day this year. We do have a few students who are going to go and play taps for the small ceremonies that we're going to have. And to all of you, I want to thank you for allowing your students to participate in this activity this year. The week before we shut down in March of last year, I got a roster that had 81 names on it for this band this year. We are just under 50, and for various reasons, scheduling, but a lot of them were hesitation over whether we were able to do this activity safely. So I want to thank you for allowing your students to continue to be part of this program, continue to build this program. I told them, it has been a year unlike any other, but I have been proud of them for overcoming each very strange obstacle that was put in front of them along their way. This is the last song that the Blue Ridge Bands will ever play with bags on their instruments, so we are happy about that, and I think they're more happy than I am. So just a heartfelt thank you to you for allowing them to continue to be part of this program. Thanks.
I would like to take a few minutes to talk about how wonderful Mr. LaRusso, our school band director, truly is. Many of us seniors started out participating in band as 5th and 6th graders. With that being said, we were absolutely terrible. None of us knew how to count properly or even know how to blow through our instruments without squealing like a pig. At least that was my case. Mr. LaRusso was extremely patient with us and took the time to teach us individually how to learn these techniques, which made our band sound amazing to work with us. Along the years of moving forward, we all learned more and grew closer together and became such a close band family. He has pushed us to perform at our absolute best and to always practice, and most of us did. Many of us performed at many big and special events, but to Mr. LaRusso, we wouldn't have made it here without you. As us seniors graduate into the upcoming classes, we appreciate all the hard work you have put into this band, even during the rough times with the Ford trip incident, COVID, and many students leaving the band. COVID hit the band class hard. Never would we have thought that this would be our last and only band concert this year, that we would have to wear a mask and a bag over our instrument while playing all at the same time. It was tricky, but you still pushed us to succeed and try our best. You may not realize it, but you, Mr. LaRusso, have played such a huge role in our lives, impacted us in many ways that none of us can even bear to explain. You've brought happiness into the school, a class we look forward to every day, and you've taught us patience. We will always miss walking in the band room with the excitement, just curious to see what jokes you were going to crack that day, and the comebacks you would have with the rest of the class, especially Malachi. You love and appreciate every single one of your students, and you make each and every one of us make us proud of our playing skills. The day you said to me, "I'm so glad you are back," after I decided to be virtual for months, I've never felt so accomplished and appreciated to be part of something so special throughout my years at Blue Ridge. Our band is, and I believe, will always be full of laughter and fun, memorable times. Let me tell you, Mr. LaRusso can fire back jokes faster than I can count to one. And even when he couldn't think of something, there was always something in hand that would often be stretched at Malachi through some smart remark. But don't worry, no injuries were caused in the doing. Overall, Mr. LaRusso, thank you for everything you've done. You have left such an amazing mark on our lives that we will never forget. This class may just be the hardest thing to leave as we graduate, and we truly can't thank you enough. And to the rest of the band, us seniors are proud of you. You have all worked hard and sound amazing. We wish you all the best. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
how.
Yeah. You mean like from the beginning?
Yeah.
Oh. No. Yeah, just sit and play with it.
Okay.
Do you need me? Aren't you guys gonna face that way? Okay. You good? Alright.
There are no notes on.
Oh, after this.
So when you stand, go.
Okay.
Whoa,
I'm so sorry. Everyone, Noah Guzzi, our drumline leader. Yay! Back in the bank. Oh, John Van Dyke.